It's that time again, time to answer your Facebook questions about the coronavirus. And joining us to do that is the Lieutenant Governor and the state's COVID-19 liaison, Dr. Josh Green. Good morning, Lieutenant Governor. You ready for the questions?
You bet.
Okay, the first question is from Hipa Neria. Hipa's asking, can the state have a hospital or place for the unvaccinated people to be treated and have all the unvaccinated healthcare workers work there too? Like the unvaccinated want to exercise their freedom, can the healthcare workers exercise their freedom not to treat the unvaccinated to protect themselves?
It's interesting that that comes up a lot, but not likely. Really, we treat everyone equally and with the same dignity and respect that we can offer them. I understand people's frustration with those who might have chosen not to get vaccinated and therefore putting others at risk, or even the rare healthcare worker who has not yet been vaccinated. But that's why we have masks and the PPE and everything to keep people safe. And now 90% of our whole state has initiated vaccination who's eligible, so it's not really been a problem. We do have the tents available, though, for people who have very mild illness, and we're using those to give things like monoclonal antibodies in.
We've been having a lot of sports questions come up. Here's another one. Jerry Keola wants to know, why can the ILH sports still play, but OIA sports shut down? What is the difference besides being public and private organizations?
There's really no difference whatsoever, although some of the private schools definitely have vaccinated more people overall. My general concern is that we get people back to normal and that if people go and get vaccinated, they are quite safe. So I'm going to continue to advocate with the governor and the mayors to allow sports, all sports, to allow people to have spectators if they're vaccinated. I think that makes sense.
Yeah, a lot of parents eager to watch their kids again. All right, Nicole Lambert-Hurt is asking, with Oahu being at 70% vaccinated, which was the governor's goal, shouldn't restrictions on the island be lifted? We are separated by ocean water from the other islands that have not reached the target vaccination goal.
Yes, restrictions should gradually be scaled back, and I think that's the prerogative of the mayor, and Mayor Blangiardi has tended to want to do that. And the things that happen on Oahu, not just sports, but also the UH football games, not just high school sports, that is. But everything will gradually get ratcheted back a notch. I just think people were traumatized by the really high hospital numbers and the counts that averaged 850 per day last month. It was only a month ago, September 3rd, actually this month, but 3.5 weeks ago, when we saw those peaks. And so I think there's a little bit of a reluctance to go quickly. But I do think that come mid-month, October, you'll see a lot of the restrictions begin to back off. And I think you're going to feel quite normal in November, provided we continue to do this well.
Finally, Sandy Hansen wants to know, as Hawaii hospitals reach capacity and we have people coming to ERs for serious emergencies, how do we prioritize? How do we accept an unvaccinated COVID patient over a stroke or coronary incident? Is there a plan in place for dealing with this?
There is. Right now, we have more than enough capacity. It did get very close to full capacity across the whole system on September 3rd, 4th, 5th. That's when we were at our worst. But since then, we've dropped by 45%. The way we do it in the hospital, and I can speak to this personally as an ER doctor, we take the person who is sickest and most likely to die. We take them first, and we prioritize them like we would for any family member or any citizen. I know it is frustrating for some people to reflect on the fact that some people could have prevented getting COVID by being vaccinated or at least preventing getting very sick. But we love everyone equally, and we're trying to encourage people to get there through science and good decision making. But if someone's had a stroke and they're more likely to die in the immediate future, we take care of them immediately. Same thing for heart attacks, same things for COVID. And we've come through this well, but I'm greatly worried, concerned about the whole mainland situation. Many of those states have not vaccinated their people, and they're going to see these large surges in the hospital like we experienced back in early September. So I'm advocating to help them too. But Hawaii is foremost on my mind, and we're coming through this okay.
All right. Well, the capacity here is getting better. Cases going down. We just hope that continues, and that's a trend we continue to see towards the holiday season. All right. Thank you so much, Lieutenant Governor, for joining us as well, and your time and your insight, always very much appreciated.
Thank you. Take care.
You too.